every single set to failure. Then when you come back to the gym, fuck it, you're stronger than you were when you left. I like that. That works, man. Late at night, man. Let's get it on. This workout's gonna test you guys. It's gonna break you too. But in doing so, it's gonna grow you. Just like life itself, man. You go after things, you try them. Even if you fail, you get back up and you continue to try and fail, continue to try and fail. And ensuring you never fail to try. Because nothing's impossible. Just a spelling of impossible. It's spelled I'm possible. Today we make belief of that. That's all right, guys. Fall down, man. That's a good thing. It's a thing is most people don't go hard enough to fall down. They don't go that far. It's too hard for them. They're not willing to pay the payment of pain today. It's too much for them. So they don't pay it today. Later in life, they pay it. And regret coming up short in something. They pay it then. What I'm trying to say is no matter who you are, everyone's gonna pay that payment one way or another. You either pay it here on your terms, when no one's watching, or you pay it later coming up short. And here, I ensure I hit failure, so I don't hit failure out there. I'll fall down fucking 10 times. Who gives a shit? As long as I get up 11. Knock me down. All day long, knock me down. Knock me down 10 times. Watch me get up 11. You know, excuses, fear, they're all created by the individual. There's a solution through it all. There's confidence to combat any kind of fear you have. But you gotta be willing to fail in order to succeed. You gotta be able to take that winnable gamble. And you believe in yourself. It comes out with the belief upstairs. You know, they always say mind never matter. And that's so true. But if you don't give a shit about it, meaning you don't mind, well then it doesn't matter to you. So who gives a fuck what the outcome is? You know? That giant oak in the forest was nothing more than a seed at one point. It's just the growth of something. And it starts that seed is inside. The belief in what you, how you see yourself in the mirror. How you see where you can go. The perception of the truth being more valuable than what the underlying truth is itself. But what everyone else says is the truth. How you see it is more powerful. And that belief is perishable. Every day you gotta build that. You build it by going here, pushing failure and beyond. You're like, God damn, man. I didn't know I could do that. I just did it and I'm exhausted, but I feel pride. I feel like I did something today. That right there adds up to be that oak in the forest that stands the test of time. That rises taller than anyone else. Now, it sounds like, you know, metaphors, whatever else. Well, it's the truth, man. Truth. If you look at any athlete out there, guys, any one of your heroes, I guarantee you, if you listen to any of their interviews, you'll hear them say, practice makes perfect, that kind of mentality, that they failed in order to succeed. Well, just keep swinging, keep swinging, keep swinging. My dad always said, just keep throwing shit against the wall, something eventually sticks. It's the belief. There's so many examples in the Olympics, and every day we see the common man with the odds against them, overcoming what people thought could never happen. And probably he didn't even think it. But there he stands, victorious, and a role model to all of us. Like, oh my God, we want to be him. But before he was him, he was us. What got him there was an undying belief. And every drop of sweat that came out, and every pain and ache and everything else, was just a telltale sign that he's getting closer and closer to that dream that we were when we were kids of being a reality. The kid inside of you, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, whatever age you are, when you were a kid, big dreams, big aspirations, anything's possible, every window is wide open to you. If you now as an adult turn back to the kid at 8 years old, the same person, is that kid proud of you? Is that kid saying, that's who I want to be? If not, open your eyes and fix the motherfucker. And when you believe that you have the ability to do something, that the life that you're living right now is going down this direction, you fucking hate where it is,
There is nothing else to do but to change direction. A belief that I cannot go that way anymore. I gotta go this way. And what do you have to lose? You know the outcome if you continue the same shit. Just commit one time in your life to something. See what happens. There are no losers in the world of passion and commitment to something. No one loses there. The losers are the people that sit the starting line and never initiate. Show up. Even if you get knocked on your ass, show up. At least you have a possibility. You have a chance. You have a voice of doing something with your fucking life. Believe that supremacy exists. Believe it within you. Because every motherfucker that had ever achieved it had to believe it when everyone else said it wasn't possible. They said it fucking was. And there they stand. Boom, did it, bitch. Believe in the difference you can be. Stop being average when your potential is crying to come outside you more than that. You're committed. And when you're committed with that belief, you expect the pain to come. You expect adversity to come. You expect troubled times to come. You welcome that. Because that's the heat, the obscured nature that's required for you to change that betterment, to have a superiority mentality. You welcome that. Because your belief is so strong, you are committed. Set out to do something, went through it, along the way, faced adversity, faced the pain, right in the eyes, kept going past it. Pain, temper, cry forever. Completed, check that motherfucker. But continue to do that, man. Only one place to go. Whew, up. Big smile, guys. Big smile. I hope you guys get what the fuck I'm saying. I'm telling you what, man, once you get it, come on over this side of the fence, you don't see fucking problems anymore, man. You see situations. You see possibilities. And you can't wait to get them started, man. And your imagination, guys, whether you want to believe it or not, is a preview of your life's coming attractions. And if you can't imagine what it's going to be, don't ever expect physically to look in the mirror and see it.
And then we're going to really light the fire of growth here in the backyard. The sandbag offensive body shock. Coming live. Okay. Now guys, I don't know if you can, it's about 50, 60 pounds, something like that. It adds up, man. Especially when you're winded and you're breathing heavy. It adds up. You guys can't do this much weight. Maybe this state, at this state in it, whatever else, you know, you only do body weight stuff and not elevated. That's fine. It doesn't matter. You might want to start this workout earlier in the session. You know, it's up to you when you want to put it in there. But don't get disgruntled if you can't do this. You know, this state in the game, you will be eventually. Don't get fixated on the speed of the progression of growth you're seeing. Don't be scared about slow growth. Be scared about standing still. And if you continue to drop water drops on an unmovable rock, eventually it'll burn a hole right through that rock. Same with your perseverance. Always showing up, eventually you'll find your window of success. Sometimes you gotta take that leap of faith, you know? All hesitant, you're sitting there with reserved feelings, anxieties, and you're hesitant to take that leap, and you're standing right there on the edge, and you're like, I don't know if I should go, and your body say no, and everything else, and you know, stop. Don't make that leap then, because who's about to jump is not all of you. That jump of life is too hard, guys. Take a step back, get your wits about you, your confidence, so when you do take that leap, that step back allows you to launch yourself over. Because you're launching with 110% of your belief behind you. You always land on solid ground that way. But if you miss your mark and you fall, I promise you, on your way down, that safety net of life will appear. You'll figure it out along the way. Huh? I did. Now keep going though, keep going. Your imagination, guys. is a preview of your life's coming attractions. For me, man, I'm really attracted to see that preview. I can't wait for what's about to come. I look forward to it. I'm not fearful of it, because I'm paying my dues now to open that present of life later. That's the reward. I'm putting the work now to make sure when I unwrap that, something that puts a smile on my face, a song in my heart, that's worth all the sweat equity, all the failures in life, all the short successes, everything that's added up to create those moments. Don't be scared to fail. I know it sucks at times, but we all do it. It's far better, guys, to have gone and failed than to never try to succeed, never put any effort out there to want to further yourselves. If your day doesn't challenge you, don't ever expect to be changed by it. That's what adds up to be the difference. All these little opportunities are in your wheelhouse. You create them. Champions are never woken up and born into success. They're created, they're matured, they'll struggle, then weather through that effort of hard work and dedication and sacrifice to achieve that championship status. It's these moments, these decisions we make on a daily basis. Do we get up early and go for a run? Do we hit the snooze button? Do we go that extra rep in the gym and our body's dying? Do we push past that? All these little things are the inches that add up to be the measure of difference between first place and forever forgotten. The dangerous part is when somebody believes in themselves. That's when they're armed and fucking dangerous. When you fall in love with the transformation, the construction site that other people say, caution, excuse me, pardon me for inconvenience and everything else, for the way this looks, I don't pardon shit. But you believe in the process, you continue the journey. And what happens is it starts to become alive. It starts to take fruition. You see it. You go from weak to strong, back again, from soft to hard. The transformation in between, no one wants to look at. You gotta put up the fucking signs and shit. You gotta apologize for making yourself better. Who the fuck is believing that? That's fucking bullshit. Everyone wants this to be great, but no one wants to put the work into it. So they're just a fucking wannabe. No one wants to be more than that. Because a wannabe into a wannabe more calls effort, action, to do something with your life. Calls the nail, the bolts, and the tools will come out. They get turned on, the sweat equity is dripping and believing in something. Everyone else is like, oh, I'm so sorry, but just, you know, it looks bad. This is a transformation, guys, into greatness. You don't want to be what we were. We don't want to even be what we came in this fucking gym as. We want to be fucking more. Then every fucking drop of sweat. Every fucking rep is making us believe that this journey that we are fucking on is winnable. What are your questions? What the fuck are your questions? In all honesty, people question things and they sit down and they, hey, what do I do here, what do I do there? Guys, one day, you gotta graduate in life. You can't always be the pupil, you gotta be the master. You gotta be the guy that's creating the material for others to try to study from. You can't always ask a question, you're asking a question because you don't believe in the journey you're about to embark on. Mentally, you must believe it before you physically start it. Otherwise, you'll never reach your prosperity. Your questions will be figured out. When you hit rock bottom and you fail and you hit the fucking pavement, you'll learn to fucking catch yourself. That's the lesson you never forget. Stop trying to love everybody else. Believe in yourself as enough of a reason to transform into something great. Stop sitting back saying, yeah, man, that'd be cool, I wanna be this, I wanna be that. Grab your fucking nuts and be it. Arm yourself in there, and every day you're starting to sharpen your arsenal. You're willing to sacrifice today for tomorrow's betterment. You're willing to pay those payments of pain, because that pain is just a message that you're fixing something that's insufficient in your life. Now it becomes exciting. But really, more than staying fit, man, helping you believe that being fit is the only fucking option. And majority, 60% of all billionaires are self-created. Think of that, guys. Because what that means is that these guys are no different than us. They had an idea, or they had an opportunity to slap them in the face at any given time. And if we think about it and we dissect our day, we have opportunities coming up every single day. It's our ability or inability to notice them and then to react to them. So what happens with these opportunities that come and go? They produce a byproduct of water. When I say water, two different types of water. One's powerful and one's submissive. The submissive one would be tears of water, crying. The powerful water is the sweat that comes out. Both water, right? So my question would be, for all these people that cry out there, they cry about opportunities missed instead of smiling for opportunities lived. First set, shaking like a wet dog already. Instead of opportunity I'm talking about, I'm not crying, baby. I'm sweating and smiling about the moment. The opportunity, not crying about the missed opportunity. Smile about the opportunity that has just lived. But why are we doing that, guys? We're doing that because it adds a little bit of fun to the workout, a little bit of a performance grade. Otherwise, self-benign and monotonous. It's the same old fucking helmet. Let's put some fun into this, you know? You never realize you're doing cardio when you're playing basketball, do you? No. So maybe you have some fun here, catch and go. We don't even realize we're ripping up our triceps. That's what we're trying to do, guys. Think outside the box. Self-generate our success. Fuck the handbook someone else wrote. It's your life, your book. Here we go. So we're gonna come up, switch it. Now I feel good. It's like a drug, guys. It's like a drug. Success is as addictive of a drug as any chemical drug. It's a high, so your endorphins released. Naturally, you don't need to shoot up for it, you don't need to snort, you guys gotta sweat for it, and the results are something that build on each other instead of deteriorating you and breaking your foundation down. This shit right here, guys, is the cornerstone to every mother monumental task and achievement that you're proud of for the rest of your life. This drives into a foundation of legacy. Some people think working out is torture. It's hard. It's painful. It's not torture, though. What torture is when pain's applied on you against your will. That's fucking scary. That's what happens when you don't give it your all every day. Become the person you want to be. Someone takes advantage of you. And here, it's not torture. It's pain. Pain, just weakness leaving the body, guys. Self-imposed fear that you're controlling and eliminating. There ain't no torture here. Torture is when you don't give it your all. Next exercise. The holy ground. The holy ground that created the life form, the energy, the fucking voltage of life. That higher ground's within us too. It must start with belief. It's the belief of what we can be. It's what who the fuck you are sees from within. That's the holy ground, guys. Be the individual. The one that creates trends others go from. That's evolution, my friends. That's how it works. Listen to the voice from within, the energy inside, knowing you can be more than this. Where there are no limitations, excuses, negative energy. It's just high voltage of positive energy. Because this day is the start of evolution. Or the person you always remember for, called legacy, motherfucker. Everybody has a 24-hour day. It's very few use all 24 hours for the betterment of what tomorrow can be. Today, we take this hour and a half workout, and we ensure we have no regrets on what's coming. Because things like limitation, fear, excuses, they don't exist. We left them at the fucking door with our ego. We're in here only for betterment. Let's go. Focus on the positive energy of the pain. That pain
is letting you know you're fixing something that's insufficient in your life. Making room for strength, growth, the belief to come out from the cracks. So no longer are you gonna be a subject matter bullshitter. You're gonna be a subject matter fucking expert. I push past that. By pushing past that, once I sit here now, done. The pain is gone. What's left now? Pride felt for job well done. Excited to do some more good work in the future here. In this hour and a half, I've dedicated myself to the betterment of myself. It's about training to be first place. That's what fucking matters, guys. When you're doing this and you're giving your all and come off that set, feeling that pump, man. You know you just made a difference. You know what you're doing counts. You do that shit every single day. You build first class status. That's the thing with life, man. Everything you want in life, you can have. You can have all you want in life. Because who the fuck you are now stands there in a dominating force who took the advantage of the time they had and now is reaping the reward of the seeds they planted today and yesterday and the days before, bearing the fruit of their potential of what they can be. No regrets. No wonders of what if. Just damn sure proud and excited of what's gonna come, what's gonna be. That's a good fucking day, man.